Drinks. Hi to all these drinks. When we have on the bridge Obi, no pitch. But when we have Sul Ponticello Estremo, I want to hear pitch. So don't be too careful. Yeah. It will be just fine if you do exactly what's written. And if there is a big crescendo, don't be afraid to do it. Yeah. It is not only very delicate. Sometimes they do very wild movement.
First parts of this opera, when it was recorded, I think a year ago, just to give you a basic idea of what's happening. Orchestra, of course, but most importantly, maybe, there is a huge electronic multi-channel part. So it may be the case that in today's readings, sometimes the music sounds rather empty. And the reason is simply that the electronics play a huge role, so we don't hear them. And I've asked to have the opportunity to hear some of the electronic parts so you can understand the style. So after the break, we will be able to listen to some of the electronics to give you an idea of, a better idea of the style. But our job for the next 2 days is to make a working recording from Act 4 until the end.
So we can start to listen now, Carlo, Sylvain?
Wait a second, just a second.
Okay.
Yeah, it's not unison. It should not, don't try to be together. It's 1, 2, 3, 4. Good to know. Papa. Yeah.
Yeah. Can you make the why is it repeating so fast?
Maybe because this is how the calculation works. It takes this takes windows in the same.
Is it possible to make the window bigger?
Yeah.
Let's do the window bigger.
是他小了 put it back again
来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来 better, yeah. And tell me, why does the voice sound a little bit... It doesn't sound completely normal. It's like cutting some of the frequencies.
Because this is the high register.
Okay, that's clear. Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. Now it sounds more. The project has to do with a play that Luc Perceval did, and that play is called Front. And it is about First World War. So my reaction first was, oh no, I wrote my first opera, Pnima, about the Second World War. Because I'm, you know, my parents are survivors, and Pnima is the experience of the children of the survivors. And it's not really about the Second World War, because it's more about the experience of trauma and how you communicate or cannot communicate the trauma. When I saw Front, I was very hesitant. It was a very strong piece, but I didn't know if I can insert myself in it and really do something meaningful with it. And then, as I was talking to Luc Perceval, I realized that he is extremely open and that he is really interested, actually, in rediscovering Front. And then he, as we were talking and as we continued to talk, he said, you know, I'm ready to open it wide open. And then I actually became hooked. As I was writing the piece, I understood that the topic of my opera is actually not the tunnel, the endless tunnel of not knowing, but the topic is vitality. The topic is, how do we continue when we are in this situation, when we don't know, where the news are every day worse and worse and worse, and we don't have control over what is happening. But we keep hearing about it or feeling it and getting the result of it. And how do we continue? How do people continue after what happened in Paris? How do you continue the next day? What makes you continue? And the search of this beginning of that atom of vitality that makes us continue. And of course, if we continue, we must have some hope. We don't just continue depressive. Something that pulls us to continue, it's something that has a lot of hope. So this is what the opera is about. And the music plot is going down and down and down over the first three scenes. We are going down and down and down to deeper and deeper and deeper layers of kind of almost subconscious suffering, but also opening, because, you know, when you suffer, a lot of things open up many times, not always. Sometimes they close up, but when there is a suffer that you didn't cause, there are acts of terrible cruelty, but there are also acts of amazing grace, you know. I will read to you the score of the electronics, and what you hear here is what we call neutral, which is basically kind of a white noise which is moving all the time. I call it moving neutral, and it's something like... So just this kind of noise. It has no pitch, but it's constantly moving, and it can go up but it's moving very, very slowly, so it seems like it's not changing. Then you have what we call Doppler. It's a big noise that can move like a whole swat of air moved. Like that. And that is what you see with those drawings, how it moves. It's unpredictable, and yeah. And once it moves, it makes a lot of movement. All right, and then we have electricity lines, which is really like really noise of electricity, but in lines. Then we have the noise of the train that we had throughout the whole piece, noise of Morse. And then cloud of electric points, which is not the lines of electricity, but that clouds of, you know, all kinds of clouds of electricity, three kinds. So you have nothingness, and then suddenly everything together for a second, and then for another, you know, many, many seconds, almost nothing, or kind of nothing, barely moving, or a little bit moving, until the next train. The time now. I'm excited, but I'm also very peaceful. I'm also very peaceful because I have so much confidence in everybody. They are really amazing. All the people participating here are amazing. You will meet them. I am five minutes early. I hate it when people come to me 5 minutes early, like to a lesson or something. My mother, when I was 4 years old, my mother registered me to a ballet class. And in the end of the year, the teacher called my mother. She had a meeting with every mother. And she said to my mother, you know, your daughter is not going to be a dancer. She's not going to be a dancer. But on the other hand, whenever the pianist is doing a mistake, your daughter goes like that. So maybe she should study piano and not ballet.
It's just this one bar.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, it's just the end of the bar. Instead of going up, you're going down.
That's right.
Do you guys just want to do that together now? Let's start on E flat, and we don't even have to do it in time, but just the bar 5 9.
Yeah, it's almost not here, but here to here.
43?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the whispered one?
Mm-hmm.
The sky.
So on a pure A, you're on a real A, so...
I've been working at it.
I got the note from Vincenzo, we tried it, it seems to work.
It seems to work,
we'll try it to see how it goes.
It's just, I have no idea why I didn't do it like this in the first time.
Oh, wow.
David, what did you think about this small chapter?
Oh, it's fine,
The scenography was the result of a talk between Chaya and me
about dark and light, day and night, death and life, because it's for me very much balancing between life and death. That's the way Philip, the scenographer, came in the game, and that was actually his task, to think about how to make six different images in a space that is evolving from very dark to very light. And so we came up with a suggestion to build this kind of lock, I call it. It's a black wall with enormous doors that are opening and where the light is coming in. And when the light is coming in full, then it's full day. And when these locks are closed, it's dark as night.
Voor lichtstand 45 en video blackout. En go.
Doe maar 47.
Weet ik niet, dat moet dan een leuk vraag.
Thank you.
Ja, ja. Ja.